Anyway, let's open the box. That looks really good. Yep. Looks really good. The item is correct. Treated well. Coil feels nice and loose, which is very good. That's a problem. That solder connection there is broken. That there, that's actually, and it's been pulled through and quite badly resoldered. So I don't know if we can repair that. We'll see. But the way this transaction's gone, I'm not holding too many hopes. So let's do a continuity check. Ohms. 15 ohms is the impedance, so we should be looking at a DC, I guess, somewhere between 12 and 14. Let's have a look in the solder tabs. Open circuit. Open circuit. Let's go a bit further and see if we can get any impedance on the wires. So the solder tabs read zero, so that's open circuit. Sorry, they read open circuit, not zero. But then we go over here onto the braid, we get 12.4, which is very good, which is correct. However, this speaker is faulty. Luckily, I think I know how to repair it. A telltale sign, I don't know if you can see this. Let's have a look here. Oh, there we are. Yep. Is this wire here, this wire on the inside, is very straight. It should actually have a little bit of a curve to it, because as this cone vibrates in and out, that wire has to have some extra length to compensate for the vibration. This is clearly broken right here. Oh look, it actually is broken, and it's just sitting in there. So that's interesting. And the stupid thing is that if when you try and fix this problem, you make that wire very tight just by pulling it through and resoldering it, you in fact create a secondary stress point where the wire joins onto the cone, and then it fails there, and then you're in real trouble, and then you have to start hacking into the cone to repair it. Here we have the wire that is completely detached from the soldering tab, and it's just broken. It may have broken off on the other side of this little rubberized tension holder here. The owner has pulled it through and possibly attempted to resolder it, and maybe been successful at one point there, and then it's just broken again because there's not enough wire. So that's all very interesting. I guess we'll have to wait and see whether or not the speaker itself works. There's the phone.